I'm gonna define top left, and I'm gonna define a top right, and these are just standard coordinates. Okay, so what we need with this is a coordinate data type, and let's call it just chord. Okay, and what this is going to have is an X component, and a Y component. Oh, actually, it's just going to be a tuple. Oh, X and Y is probably helpful. So that it's self-explaining which axis is which. Okay, and now we had the function area widths. So what we want to do is to know the horizontal difference between top left and bottom right. So what I really would like to do is to write a function that subtracts coordinates from each other. Let's do that. I'll put that right here. It takes a coordinate and a coordinate and returns the difference of the two. So what this actually does is it takes these and returns a coordinate that actually says if this does what it's supposed to do. Probably. Let's see if we need those here. Prettiest function I've ever written. Don't really know what the problem is here. Let's see if he wants that on one line. Ah, should read the error messages. So, it's on line 5, the actual problem. Right up here. And now it compiles. Okay, so if we subtract top right from top left, if we subtract top left from top right, then we can very easily have the widths. Okay, so let's pull that function up here so that we know what we're working with. So I'm taking a pixel area and I want to know the widths. So what that means is I want to do p top right area minus p top left area, and get the x component of that. And that means we also have the height. If we take the y component. Okay. And now we're ready to start doing some testing on this, so that we know that we're on the right track. Let's move this down again, away from the data types. This is the basic layout. I'd love to show you more in the next installment. And yeah, so we've got the basic setup, we've got a function to recognize text, by recognizing lines, which works by recognizing chars, which compares letters to the actual text, and which works by comparing the actual areas. Now there's a lot of implementation and a lot of testing that I would like to start next, but so much for this first video. Thank you so much.